Now, itong next problem natin, this is similar sa previous problem na sinolve natin using three-moment equation. So, meron din tayong moment load applied directly at point C. Ayan. So, we can fast track this one since again, alam na natin yung approach kapag merong moment load na applied at a certain support. So, what we will do here is we will first establish our points. Now, it would be tempting to use this one as our first point. Diba kasi naka A, B, C, D, E, F yung span natin. But notice na itong point A, this is a free end. Diba? So, since free end yan, merong deflection dyan. So, pangit siyang gamitin sa three-moment equation kasi magkaka-value yung H1. So, ano yung points pala natin? Ano yung magandang points dyan? Again, kapag if you're using the three-moment equation for indeterminate beams, mas maganda pag lahat ng points mo nasa support. Kasi sa support, again, walang deflection dyan na mangyayari. So, on the same elevation lahat, meaning we can make H1 and H3 equal to 0 kapag lahat ng points natin are along the same line. So, dito pala tayo magsa-start. Dito sa roller support. Kasi alam natin na walang deflection dyan. So, let me treat this one as my point 1. Ayan. And then, this one, iti-treat ko as point 2. Itong pangalawang roller support. And then, my point 3 would be dito naman sa fixed support. Now, notice here na meron tayong dalawang unknowns. Hindi natin alam yung M2, hindi rin natin alam yung M3. Yung M1, since it's beside the overhanging end, makocompute lang natin yan. So, we have two unknowns, 2 and 3 moments sa 2 saka 3. Therefore, we would need to form another equation. Kailangan dalawang equations yung ma-form natin to solve the two unknowns. Kasi diba kung ilan yung unknowns mo, yan din yung dapat na equations na mabubuo mo. So, gagawin natin, we will have to use an imaginary span. So, this is usually the case kapag meron kang fixed end. So, this will be your fourth point. Yan. So, this imaginary span can be used para ma-consider natin yung point 2, 3, 4 naman. Again ha, sa three-moment equation, we always need 3 points. Now, yung maganda sa imaginary span, wala siyang length, wala din siyang moment. So, magiging madali yung solution natin kapag ito yung i-consider natin. So, our point 1 would be, again, dito sa roller. Lahat ng points na yan are on the same elevation. So, ibig sabihin, walang value yung H1, H3, saka sa second equation din. Sige, so, let's first try to compute ano yung M1, L1, ano yung values niya. So, dito tayo sa M1 muna. The value of M1, hindi yan magiging 0 kasi diba, hindi yan siya nasa left end. So, magkaka-moment siya due to the following loads. This one, and also this uniform load acting sa overhang. Meron silang influence dyan sa moment. So, our M1 would be 10 kilonewtons multiplied by 3 meters going to point B. Now, counterclockwise yung rotation na makakos niya. So, minus pala. Minus 10 tapos multiplied by 3. Ayan. And then, we also have the resultant of this distributed load. So, lagay ko dito. Now, this would be 2 yung load natin multiplied by 3 meters. And then, this distance naman going to point B, this is half of 3 meters, so 1.5 meters. And then, counterclockwise pa rin yung ikot na makukos niya. So, minus 2 times 3 multiplied by 1.5. Ayan. So, equals, ano yung value niya? Kunin na lang natin yung numerical value niya. So, negative 10 times 3, then minus 2 times 3 squared divided by 2. So, negative 39 pala. Yan yung M1 natin. Kilonewton meter. And then, yung L1 naman natin, L1 is equal to, hindi 3, hindi rin 8. Diba? Kasi yung L1 natin, it must correspond to the length from point 1 going to point 2. So, from point 1 to point 2, we have a distance of 5 meters. Yan yung magsisilbing L1 natin. So, L1 is equal to 5 meters pala. Ayan. And then, dito naman tayo sa M2. Now, yung M2 natin, unknown yan. Diba? Hindi natin malalaman, hindi kasi natin malalaman kung ano yung moment at that point. And then, meron ding influence yung BY sa moment at point 2. So, let's leave it as an unknown. So, we have M2 equals, lagyan natin ng question mark. Ayan. To signify that it's unknown. And then, L2 naman would be the length of span 2. Now, span 2 is from point 2 going to point 3. So, 5 plus 2 plus 1, we have a distance of 8. So, L2 equals 8 meters. And then, yung M3 naman natin, meron ding value yan. Kasi, diba, andyan yan sa fixed support. Kailangan meron yung value for the reactive moment. So, we would have M3 equals unknown din yan. So, yung problema na lang natin is the three moment factors, itong dalawa. H1 and H3 will just be 0 kasi yung point 1, 2, and 3 are along the same line. So, 0, 0 din yan. So, this whole expression will just become 0. So, ito na lang yung kukunin natin. 6A1 barred A1 over L1 plus 6A2 barred B2 over L2. Sige, so, gagawin natin, draw natin yung span 1 to 2. Ayan. So, we would have here BC, diba? So, lagay ko dito yung roller support natin. Ito na lang. And then, we have point C din. Gagawin pala natin tong simply supported. Diba? Para sa three moment equation. So, simply supported na yan. And then, we actually have a distributed load here. Ayan. And then, this is 2 kilonewton per meter. And then, meron din tayong moment load na 13 kNm. So, andito yan. Now, again ha, ilalagay ko sa left. So, meaning, mamaya pala, when I will solve BY, then I must use, then I must include this one. Yan, kasi located siya span 1 to 2. Masasali yan sa M2 natin, essentially. So, gagawin ko, label ko yung distance, and then, isosolve ko na yung three moment factors natin. So, we would have, for the distributed load, this would be, lagay ko ha, 6A1 barred A1 over L1. Ayan. So, for the distributed load, gagamitin ko na lang yung WL cubed divided by 4. This one. Again na, you only have to memorize this one and also this one. Ito yung tinuro ko sa last time sa previous video natin. And then, for the moment load, this is acting clockwise. Nasa pinakadulo yan. So, we would have to apply this formula. Negative M over L times 3A squared minus L squared. Now, naka-clockwise yan, the same sa orientation dito, so you can just use the formula directly. Huwag mong gawing negative yan. Iba yan sa previous example natin. So, we have minus M over L, then times 3a squared minus l squared. Ayan. So, our w is 2, l is 5, tapos naka-cube dapat, then divided by 4. Minus m over l, m is 13, length is 5. And then we have 3a squared. A is the distance from the left patungo sa concentrated moment. So we have 5 meters from the left patungo dito. So 3 times 5 squared pala. Then minus L squared, the length is 5. So 5 squared. Ayan. So makukuha na natin yung factor natin. So we would have 2 times 5 cubed divided by 4, then minus 13 over 5 multiplied by 3 times 5 squared minus 5 squared. So this would be equal to negative 67.5. Ayan. Now, we also need 6a2 barred b2 over l2. Now, that factor would already entail span 2 to 3. So, idudraw natin yan ulit. So, we have span 2 to 3. Now, yung moment natin, sinali ko na sa span 1 to 2. So, dito sa point 2 to 3, hindi ko na yan isasali. Magiging redundant kasi yan pag isasali mo ulit. So, draw natin. Ayan. So, span 2 to 3. Meron tayong triangular load applied from point D to E. 2 meters from the left and then 1 meter to the from the right. So, let's say dito. Ayan. So, this is 12 kN per m. Gagawin natin yung simply supported. Yan. Again na, this is 251. Saka 1 meter. Ayan. Now, notice na walang general formula for triangular loads not acting sa whole span. Therefore, what's ideal to do here is to apply this formula in conjunction with integration. Diba? So, the same lang sa example natin last time. So, ito yung gagamitin ko. And then, let me define this one, the starting point of the load. Yan usually yung magandang point ng origin. So, this is our origin. And then, we have x. Ayan. So, this x is variable, bale, it will increase up to this point. Ayan. So, diba, again, we can consider this as a series of concentrated loads. Ayan. Until nabuo yung linearly increasing load natin. So, itong strip natin, we can have a strip right here. Ayan. So, this would be dx. And then, this would be the height y. Ayan. So, the resultant of this particular strip would be y multiplied by dx. Ayan. Y would be the height of the uniform load sa point na to. At any point, according to the distance x. Ayan, essentially yung concept natin. So, this resultant would be equal to y dx. Yan. So, we have to define y in terms of the variable x since we are integrating with respect to x. Diba? Kasi yan yung strip natin. So, how can we define y in terms of x? Let's use ratio and proportion. Now, we can consider the whole triangle. This one. So, for the whole triangle, we have a height of 12. So, we have 12 and then this that's to a base of 5 meters. Diba? This is 5 meters man. Yung total length na yan. So, 12 over 5 equals let's consider the smaller triangle. So this is, it has a height of y and a base of x, di ba? Y over x. Therefore, we can define y as 12 over 5. Then multiply mo yung x dyan. So times x. So this would be our value of y. 12 over 5 multiplied by x. Now, itong height na y, or essentially yung resultant na to, this will act as your concentrated load at any point along this distributed load. Therefore, this would act as your P pala. Yan. Ito. So, to apply integration, by the way ha, we are interested in this formula. Since we are already nasa span 2 to 3 kasi tayo, second span. So, we would have PB over L times L squared minus B squared, where P is 12 over 5 multiplied by X. This one. Yan yung magsisilbing concentrated load natin. But again ha, this is essentially multiplied by dx. But sa dulo ko na lang imu-multiply yung dx. Now, ano yung b? If we'll try to check sa formula, b is the distance from the right end patungo sa concentrated load. So, ito yung right end. Pinaka-right end, di ba? Yung roller support. So, the distance going here would be equal to label natin na. Diba? We have this point. So, from the roller support going to this particular point, let's try to define this in terms of x. So, the total distance is, diba, 5 plus 1, 6, and then babawasan ko ng x, ito yung matitirang distance. So, this is, ano pala? 6 minus x. Now, b is variable kasi kapag, if our load moves, let's say, andito na yung load natin, ito na yung magiging b. So, this is actually variable, kaya, we have to express it in terms of x. So, p times b, our b is 6 minus x, then divided by l. Now, what is l? Our L is yung total length. So, 2 plus 5 plus 1 magiging 8. Yan, divided by 8. And then, L squared minus A squared, we would have, I mean, L squared minus B squared pala. This would be 8 squared minus B squared. Yung B natin, 6 minus X pa rin. So, 6 minus X, tapos, kailangan naka-square yan. Ayan. So now, this would be our 6A2 barred B2 over L2. Lagay na lang natin. 6A2 barred B2 divided by L2. Ayan. So, ito yung reason bakit yung moment load nilagay ko na lang sa span 1 to 2. Kasi kapag nilagay ko siya dito, di ba, it will be transmitted right here. Pag ilalagay ko siya dyan, if I will consider 0.234, masasali ulit yung moment load. So, bale, hahaba yung solution. Now, I'm trying to streamline the solution, so kaya, dito na lang sa left. Pwede nyong itry, and then, the same value lang yung lalabas. Pero mas, again, mas hahaba yung solution. Sige, so, copy ko to. Yan. But again, we still have to integrate this one. Integrate natin from the origin, 0, up to the length, 5 meters. Only considering the application of the load. Kasi yan yung kinonsider natin na origin, starting point ng load, ending point is the termination point of the load. So, this would be from 0 to 5. Ayan. Integrate from 0 to 5. So, input ko na lang yan. Integral and then 0 to 5. Then we have 12 over 5x times 6 minus x, then divided by 8, tapos 8 squared minus 6 minus x, tapos naka-square din. So press equals, we have 523.75. Ayan. So ito yung factors natin para sa span 1, 2, 3. Now, we would have to consult another span. So dito na tayo sa span 2, 3, 4. But before that, let's try to formulate na lang the three moment equation. So we have, again, this one. Our M1 is negative 39. So we would have negative 39. And then what is L1? L1 is 5. Diba? So negative 39 times 5. Then plus 2 M2. M2 is unknown. Then we have L1 plus L2. 5 plus 8. Then plus M3, which is also unknown. Then multiplied by L2, which is 8. Yan. Now, 6A1 barred A1 over L1 is negative 67.5. Ayan. And then, 6A2 barred B2 naman is 523.75 plus. So, this would be equal to 0. Kasi again, the heights here would be equal to 0. So, we can simplify the equation. 2 times 13, di ba? 5 plus 8, 13. 13 times 2, magiging 26M2. Let's try to isolate the variables and then lahat ng constant terms, imu-move na lang natin sa right side ng equation. And then, yung M3, merong 8. Yan yung coefficient niya. So, plus 8M3. Then, taking the opposite signs of the constant terms, we would have 39 times 5. Magiging positive na kasi yan. Then, plus 67.5. Then, minus 523.75. So, press equals, we have negative 261.25. Ayan. Double check ko lang ah. I think, tama na yan. So, we have negative 261.25. This is our first equation. Yan. So, our second equation would already entail span 2, 3, 4. So, gagawin ko, let's draw span 2 to 3. So, diba, the same lang yan dito. This is still span 2 to 3. Ayan. Now, our equation for the second span, ito na. Since we are considering span 2, 3, 4, M2 yung left moment natin, then middle is M3, then right is M4. Ayan. So, notice na yung L2, this will already become our span 1. Therefore pala, sa formula na to, ito dapat yung gagamitin natin. Yan. Kasi this is already span 1 para sa points 2, 3, 4. So, ito pala. Babaguhin ko pala to. Yan. Tatanggalin ko yan. Hindi na kasi B yung kailangan natin. A na yung kailangan natin. Now, A is the distance from the left patungo sa concentrated load. Now, ito yung left end, then going to the concentrated load, yan yung resultant natin, diba, this is A, which is 2 plus the variable distance x. So A equals 2 plus x. Ito yung ito essentially yung magbabago. So we have 6a1 barred a1 over l2, which is the integral from 0 to 5 pa rin, and then our equation would be pa over l times l squared minus a squared. Now p is still the same, ito pa rin 12 over 5 multiplied by x. Yan, this is p. Now yung a natin, ito na, 2 plus x, then divided by l is 8, and then 8 squared minus a squared, so 2 plus x, then naka-square. And then meron yung dx dito. Yung dx dito dapat sana naka-multiply talaga, realistically or practically. Pero dito ko na lang ilalagay kasi yan yung syntax ng calculator natin. So input na lang natin yung factors. Wala namang ibang loadings dyan. So we would have 0 to 5. Again, ito yung reason ulit kung bakit hindi ko nilagay yung moment load dito sa span 2 to 3. Kasi kapag andyan yung moment load, then I would have to add another 3 moment factor para dito. So hahaba talaga yung solution. So again, 12 over 5 multiplied by x, then times 2 plus x, then divided by 8. Tapos 8 squared minus 2 plus x, then naka-square dapat. So press equals, we have 631.25. Now fortunately, this one, this will just be 0 kasi di ba yung span 2 natin would be 3 to 4. Now this is an imaginary span. So wala siyang length, wala din siyang moment. So automatic yung m4 l3 pala magiging 0 lang din 'yan kasi nasa imaginary span 'yan. Ayan. Saka ito rin yung factor na to, nasa imaginary span. And then yung h2 saka h4 magiging 0 lang sila kasi along the same line ng lahat ng points natin. So what would be left is are the following na lang, m2 l2 plus 2m3 l2 plus l3, then plus this expression, 6a1 barred a1 over l2. So equate mo na lang yan to 0, and then our m2 is unknown, l2 is, what is l2, diba 8, and then plus 2m3, then l2 plus l3, this will just be 8 plus 0 essentially, kasi yung l3 natin, yan yung distance from 0.3 to 0.4 horizontally. Ayan. Then plus this value. So 631.25 equals 0. So just move the constant term sa kabilang side ng equation. We would have 8m2 plus 2 times 8 magiging 16. So 16m3. Then equals negative 631.25. This is our equation 2. Yan. And so combining equation 1 and equation 2, pwede mong gamitin na lang yung calculator mo. Solve two equations, two unknowns. Ayan. Input ko na lang dito. So I will treat m2 as my x and m3 as y. So go to equation, and then ito, dito tayo sa two equations, two unknowns. Or kano na lang yung gagamitin ko, kasi ito naman yung common na calculator. So mode tayo, then equation, tapos two unknowns, press 1. Then we would have 26m2, kailangan naka-arrange yung variables, So M2 yung first, M3 yung second dapat. And then lahat ng constant terms kailangan nasa right side ng equation. So ito 8, then minus 261.25. And then we have 8, 16, then negative 631.25. Ayan. So press equals, makukuha na natin yung values natin. So for M2, we have 2.47159. So this is KNM. And then our M4 naman is negative 40.689. M3 pala, sorry. Ayan. So, ito na yung values natin. Now, essentially, yung M3 natin, yan na din yung reaction. Reaction at F. Pero, yung reaction at point F, kailangan naka-clockwise. Kasi yung, ano kasi, yung negative 40.689, parang ano kasi yan, yung moment from left saka moment from right sa moment diagram mismo. So kapag negative yan, to counteract that, kailangan meron kang clockwise na anong tawag dito? Clockwise na moment reaction. So yan lang yung ano mo talaga, yan yung dapat mong tandaan. Kapag 3 moment equation and then let's say this is fixed. Kung ano yung makukuha mong value sa sabihin natin, let's say lang ha, meron tayong fixed support. Yan, sa dalawang ends. So, fixed ended beam. Let's say, this is our point 1. And this is our point 2. Let's say lang. And then, ano na lang. Let's have an imaginary span dito. So, this is point 1, point 2, saka point 3. Now, kapag ito yung configuration ng beam mo, diba, this is fixed end, pero nasa left. Yung makukuha mong value sa M2, yan na din yung magiging moment reaction mo. Moment reaction. So, sabihin ko lang, yung M2 ha, indicates, is indicative of fixed supports na nasa left end. So, yung moment reaction, let's say we have negative 40. Therefore, the moment reaction here is counterclockwise kasi negative yung lumabas. 40 KNM. Ayan. Pero what if meron ka ng value for M3 and then let's say yung value niya is negative 40. Iba na yan. Kasi yung negative 40, yan pa lang yung parang value sa moment diagram. So, negative 40, to counteract that, kailangan meron kang clockwise na 40 para maging 0 yung moment sa pinakadulo. So, kapag negative 40 yan, this would be clockwise. Pero kapag, let's say, positive 40 yan, if this is positive 40, then this would be counterclockwise na. Yan. This, it would counteract M3. Again ha, yan yung difference kapag left na fixed end saka right na fixed end. Sa left na fixed end, automatic na yung makukuha mong value sa moment dyan, yan na din yung orientation ng moment reaction, yung direction niya. Pero sa M3, it would have to change. Be careful lang dyan kasi dyan usually nagkakamali yung mga students. Lalo na sa mga quizzes. Sige, so, balik tayo sa figure natin. And then, let's try to solve the reactions na. So, copy ko to. Ayan. Now, sulat natin yung reactions. Diba, dito sa B, meron tayong BY, then we have CY. Then, sa fixed end, we would have an upward reaction, FY. Then, we also have FX. Saka, meron din tayong moment reaction. This is M sub F. Ayan. Now, yung FX, magiging 0 lang since wala namang horizontal load na in-apply sa beam natin. So, 0 na yan. And then, let's first try to solve BY. So, to get BY, pwede akong mag-moment sa point C. Yan. Alam ko na kasi yung M2. Diba? M2 is 2.47159. But, take note na yung moment load natin na 13 kN, sinali natin sa span 1 to 2. Therefore, I would have to include 13 kN para sa solution ko in solving BY. So, ito yung mangyayari dyan. Summation of moments about 0.2, kailangan equal siya sa value ng M2 natin. Ayan. So, we have 10 minus 10 kasi counterclockwise yung ikot na makukos niya. Then, the moment arm going to 0.2 or essentially this is at point C, we have 3 plus 5. So, 8. Negative 10 times 8. And then, yung distributed load na i-consider na natin, it would be para sa buong distributed load na talaga. Kasi it's acting up to point C. So, meron tayong resultat dyan. This is 2 times the distance 8. So, 2 times 8. And then, our moment arm going to point C, this would be 5 plus 3 divided by 2 magiging 4. So, 4 meters yan. 4 meters din to, yung distance na yan. So, we would have minus, kasi counterclockwise yung rotation niya, then times 4 meters. Then, we have plus BY, and then I would have to multiply this by 5. Ayan. Then, again, don't forget to include 13 kN, so plus 13. Kasi clockwise yan. Then, this must all be equal to M2. Now, ano yung M2? M2 is equal to 2.47159. Ito. So, equate mo to. We have 2.47159. Ayan. So, negative 10, then times 8, minus 2 times 8, times 4, plus BY multiplied by 5, plus 13, equal dapat to 2.47159. So, solving BY, we have 26.6943. Ayan. And then this is in kilonewtons na. So, lagay ko na lang. 26.6943 kilonewtons. And then, again ha, yung nakuha natin sa M3, negative. Pero dapat clockwise yung reaction dito sa point F. So, we can already label this as 40.689. This is kilonewton meter. Ayan. And then, next natin masusolve, pwedeng CY yung isolve mo by taking moments about F, or pwede rin na kunin natin yung FY. Depende na yan sa preference mo. Saan ba mas maganda? I think mas maganda kapag kukunin ko na lang yung moment at C, tas kukunin ko yung FY. Kasi para ano na lang, ano tawag dito, kaunti na lang yung loads natin. So still, I would need the value of M2. But from the right na ako. Again na, basta mag-moment ka from the right, then opposite na yung convention mo. Kasi parang yan kasi yung positive effect ng beam. Therefore, clockwise movements would be negative na, then counterclockwise movements would be positive. So, still, ano pa rin, summation of movements about 0.2, equate natin sa M2. But this would be from the right. From right. Ayan. So, from the right, we have Fy multiplied by 1 plus 5 plus 2 going to point C, so 8. Fy multiplied by 8. Sir, bakit positive? Positive kasi yung Fy makukos niya na rotation about point C is counterclockwise. But again, basta mag-moment ka from the right for 3-moment equation, kailangan baguhin mo yung convention. The same lang sa moment diagram by parts natin. Ayan, so Fy times 8. Then we have MF. So MF is 40.689 clockwise. So dapat naka-plus pala. 40.689. Ayan. And then we have the resultant reaction of the triangular load, which is acting here. This is 1 half times base na 5 times a height of 12. So this is, ano yan? 2.5 multiplied by 12. So 30. 30 kilonewtons. And then this distance is 2/3. 2/3 of 5. Ayan. So, yung rotation na makukos nito is clockwise. Ah, sorry. This must be, ano pala, minus. Kasi, clockwise. So, 40.689. Again, from the right, magbabago yung convention. Clockwise is already negative. Now, yung makukos na rotation nito about point C is also clockwise. So, magiging minus din siya. Minus 30. Yan yung load. And then our moment arm is 2/3 of 5. And then plus a distance of 2 meters. Kasi ito kasi yung buong moment arm. So plus 2 pala. So Fy times 8. Ito tapos na. Saka yung MF. And then we can now equate this one to M2, which was again 2.47159. Ayan. Now sir, bakit hindi mo na sinali yung 13 kilonewton meter? Hindi ko na sinali yan kasi dito sa span 2 to 3 hindi ko nilagay dyan yung moment load. Nilagay ko yung moment load dito sa span 1 to 2. So dito lang siya masasali. Ayan. So, kapag from the right ako, essentially, wala nang effect yan, yung 13 kilonewton meter. So, ito lang dapat yung equation mo talaga. So, we would have 8x, then minus 40.689, minus 30, then times 2/3, times 5 plus 2, then equals 2.47159. So solving Fy, we have 25.395. So this is in kilonewtons. And then finally, to solve CY, we can sum up forces along Y equal to 0 for the whole structure na. Whole structure. Ayan. So we would have BY plus CY plus FY. Equate natin yung upward forces to the downward forces. So this would be equal to 10. Then plus 2 times 8. This is essentially 16. So 16 then plus 30. And then ito lang. And then we already have values for BY. BY is 26.6943. FY is 25.395. Lagay ko na lang. And then CY na lang yung unknown. So we would have 10 plus 16 plus 30, then minus 26.6943 minus 25.395. So press equals, we have 3.91. So this is in kilonewtons. So finally, i-check na natin yung mga sagot natin. So dito tayo sa application. So yung total length natin is 5 plus 3 plus 8. 16 lang, di ba? So this is 16 meters. Ayan. Tanggalin na lang natin lahat ng loads. Ayan. So meron tayong overhang of 3 meters. So this is 3, tapos this is located 8 meters from the left. So 8, ayan. Then meron tayong fixed support sa right end. Then yung loads natin, we have 10 kilonewtons dito. Then 2 kN/m applied up to the support at C. So, 2 saka 2. Ayan. Then, we have a triangular load acting from 10 meters from the left and then 5 meters yung distance niya of application. So, this is 10 meters then from 0 to 12 kasi triangular. Then, this is acting over a distance of 5. Ayan. Meron pang kulang. Meron tayong moment load sa point C. So, at 8 meters, then this is clockwise 13 kilonewton meter. Yan, 13. So, our reactions are the following. 26.694, 3.91, and 25.395. So, the same lang sa mga nakuha natin. Ayan. So, again, meron tayong multiple approaches para dito. So, pwede mong itry na ilipat mo yung moment load na to. Ilagay mo sa span 2 to 3. And then, try to check if you will obtain the same values sa reactions. Yung magbabago lang dyan is the value of M2. But, M3 will remain for as 40.689 regardless. Sige, so, I hope meron kayong mga bagong natutunan ngayon. And, I hope na you can apply this sa quizzes nyo or sa mga plates nyo. Salamat sa pagkikinig.